Good day, brethren. I thank God for this privilege to speak in one of your Holy Week devotions. And thank you for the invitation to be part of this series. This time, I will share to you about the seventh, the last or final words of the Lord Jesus Christ on the cross. Our passage is from Luke chapter 23, verse 46. I will read to you from the English Standard Version. Then Jesus, calling out with a loud voice, said, "Father, into your hands I commit my spirit." And having said this, he breathed his last. Let me read again. Luke 23, verse 46. Then Jesus, calling out with a loud voice, said, "Father, into your hands I commit my spirit." And having said this, he breathed his last. Let us pray. We praise and thank you for your word, Lord. Once again, we open our hearts as we listen and reflect upon your words. Allow us to pay attention to what your Spirit wants to teach us so that we can continue to live in obedience to you. Thank you, Lord, for the wisdom that flows from your word into our lives. This is our prayer in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Let me first get back to the previous verses. From verses 44 to 45a, it says, "It was now the sixth hour, and there was darkness over the whole land until the ninth hour, while the sun's light failed, and then the curtain of the temple was torn in two." In our time, it was about 12 noon to 3 in the afternoon. And there was darkness over the whole land. The sun ceased to give its light. And according to the Bible scholars, it was not an eclipse, but it was an unnatural darkness. Between 12 noon to 3 p.m., parang naging gabi, no? Dumilim ang paligid. And the Bible scholars call it the agony of creation, sympathizing with their creator's suffering. Kumbaga, nakikidalamhati ang mga nilalang sa pagdurusa ng kanilang manlilikha. And then, there was an extraordinary event that happened in the temple in Jerusalem. In verse 45b, it says, "While the sun's light failed, and the curtain of the temple was torn in two." The curtain of the temple was torn in two. According to Matthew chapter 27, verse 51, it was torn in two from top to bottom, mula sa itaas hanggang baba. Note, this curtain or veil was not like our window curtains. Gaya nung nakita po niyo sa aking likuran, meron pong kortina, hindi po ganyang klase ng kortina. According to the Bible scholars, it was about 4 inches thick, no? Yung kapal niya, 4 inches. And then, it's about 60 feet high. So, napakataas po nito. And it was wide, no? It was heavy. At hindi po ito basta-basta napupunit. Ano po? Dahil siya ay makapal. Ano po? And this curtain in the temple separates the Holy of Holies. Nandun po ang tinatawag na Ark of the Covenant, kung saan ito ang Diyos ay nananahan po. And they call it as the earthly dwelling place of God. This is where God dwells, no? Kaya ang tawag dun, Holy of Holies. And only the high priest, not anyone can enter that place, not even the priest enter that place, but only the high priest. The high priest, because it is holy. It is where God dwells. Now, when the Lord Jesus Christ died on the cross, that veil that separates the Holy of Holies was torn in two from top to bottom. It was opened through our Lord Jesus Christ. Anyone can now have access to God's presence. Dati ang high priest lang ang nakakapasok doon, no? To offer sacrifice and to give prayer to God in behalf of the people. But now it's open, no? Through our Lord Jesus Christ. We can now come before God's presence. Not just in Jerusalem, where the heart or center of worship of the Jews was, nor in the temple anymore, but anywhere at any time, we can come to God. We can come to His presence. Now, let's move to our main verse, verse 46. Then Jesus, calling out with a loud voice, said, "Father, into your hands I commit my spirit." And having said this, he breathed his last. Jesus cried out with a loud voice. In spite of the suffering, the beating, and lashing of the Roman soldiers carrying a heavy cross and hanging there for hours crucified, it really shows the Lord's physical strength. Talagang malakas ang katawan ng ating Panginoong Jesus. He still had the strength to cry out, to shout. And this shout, according to the Bible scholars, was not a shout of agony, but it was a shout of victory. Because it is finished, the Lord Jesus completed the task. He fully satisfied the wrath of God that we deserve because of our sins. The Lord Jesus Christ bore our sins and paid the price for us. And here in this passage, let me read to you again. Then Jesus, calling out with a loud voice, said, "Father, into your hands I commit my spirit." And having said this, he breathed his last. Here also we can see the authority of our Lord Jesus Christ. His authority over his own life and death. The Lord Jesus has the authority, and only him, only Jesus has the authority to lay down his life and the authority to take it up again. According to a Bible scholar, his name is John Schultz, Jesus did not die of exhaustion. He did not die of crucifixion. But because he commanded his spirit to leave his body and go into the hands of the Father. Jesus died because he commanded his spirit to leave his body and go into the hands of the Father. As he said, "Into your hands, Father, I commit my spirit." No human being ever dies that way. To commit means to deposit as a trust. In its original Greek word, no, its meaning was to deposit as a trust. The Lord Jesus committed his spirit as a trust in the Father's hand. John chapter 10, verses 17 to 18 says, "For this reason, the Father loves me, because I lay down my life that I may take it up again." Verse 17 again. "For this reason the Father loves me, because I lay down my life that I may take it up again." And verse 18. "No one takes it from me, but I lay it down of my own accord. I have authority to lay it down, and I have authority to take it up again. This charge I have received from my Father." It was the words of our Lord Jesus Christ. The Lord Jesus committed his spirit to God the Father, and then he died. He died and he was buried. Talagang namatay, ano po ang ating Panginoong Jesus. And on the third day, he rose to life again. Jesus was resurrected from the dead. And again, he was with the disciples, his disciples. And then he ascended to heaven. He was seated at the right hand of God. And he promised to come back again. No? Our Lord Jesus Christ is coming back again soon. Our coming King, Jesus Christ, will be back again soon. Amen. So till his last breath, Jesus communed with the Father. The last and final words of the Lord Jesus were a prayer. Ito po'y panalangin. Until his last breath, the Lord Jesus Christ was communing with the Father. He offered prayers. The last prayer before he died on the cross. It was a prayer of trust and security, being assured of the Father's love. Father, into your hands I commit my spirit. Till his last breath, Jesus committed to the Father's will and purpose, that is, even to suffer and die on the cross. It was accomplished by the Lord Jesus Christ. He committed, he submitted, he yielded to the Father's will and purpose, even to death and suffering on the cross. And till his last breath, Jesus completed his mission. Till his last breath, the Lord Jesus Christ completed his mission. When he breathed his last, Jesus brought salvation to the world. The Lord Jesus Christ brought salvation to the world. And this is my prayer. And at the same time, a challenge to you, dear brethren. May we follow our Lord's commitment in our communion with God, in yielding to His purpose, and in accomplishing our mission in Christ till our last breath and until it is finished. Purihin ang Panginoon sa kanyang mga salita. God bless us all.
Healing. could say.